Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 22. Today I'm going to be working on a photo that I took last March up in Burlington, Vermont, where the weather was cold enough to have frozen over Lake Champlain, enough for people to walk on and, as you can see, icebound this ship. Unfortunately, when I shot this photo, I wasn't paying attention to my exposure meter, and I had the camera set at like matrix metering, and as a result the camera did a great job. It did what it was supposed to do, but it ended up rendering the picture basically in gray tones, and I need to go into Lightroom and correct that in post-processing. Today I am learning about zone metering and setting my camera to spot metering so that I can actually meter off the mid-tones and check my highlights and get a better and more accurate exposure reading when I shoot my photos. But in the meantime, as I say in my post, I can come into Lightroom and correct my mistakes. So the first thing I'm going to do with this photo is I am going to actually open up the shadows because I want to recover some of the detail in this area of the boat on the right. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to open up my shadows pretty high. And as a result, because this is a global adjustment, it is now overexposed the photo, but I'm going to pull down the exposure to compensate for that. So let's bring the exposure down. Sorry, got a little carried away there. To about here. I'm just playing. And now before I move on to anything else, I'm going to crop the photo. This is kind of a loosey-goosey procedure I'm following, but I'm going to click on my crop overlay, come down, and I'm going to rotate just a bit. I want to angle, get the horizon level for the most part without cutting off too much of the upper portion of that antenna on the boat. I'm going to come in and set this manually. Okay. And then I'm going to move this over and up to the right as far as I can and click done. Okay, that's better. And at this point, I'm going to come down and I'm going to increase my clarity just a bit. And when I increase the clarity, it does remove some of the color, but it does make the textures more defined. I'm going to leave it about there. And because it took out just a hint of color, I'm going to boost the vibrance to capture some of that lovely blue in the boat and the sky, which is how it looked when I was there. Then my next step will be to come into the tone curve. I'm going to choose the medium contrast curve just to give some just a little bit more boost to the photo. But now I want to do a little bit more with spot adjustments. And I'm going to come in. I want to darken down the left side of the photo to emphasize the boat, which is the focal point of this photo. So I'm going to come into my graduated filter tool. And I'm going to start at the left side of my photo, holding down the shift key. As I pull, hold my mouse and drag to the right will ensure that the line stays vertical. And I'm going to pull this pretty much over here. And then I'm going to play back and forth with moving the adjustment. And I'm going to set the exposure. You'll see it's at -32. Let's see what happens when I darken that. You can see where that moves just a bit. And I'll keep it there for right now. And then what I would like to do is I'm going to create another graduated filter, and I'm going to increase the exposure and the clarity on the right. So again, dragging, holding and dragging. Oops, what am I in? Let's come back to the graduated filter. There we go. Holding and dragging from the right, holding down shift. I'm going to pull this over. I'm going to let go of shift, and I'm going to just move around for a minute. I'm going to open up the shadows. I'm going to play with this. Let's see. I'm going to open up the shadows just a little bit more, and I'm going to boost the clarity. Oops. I'm going to boost the clarity, entering manual numeric value, and I'm still going to play with pulling this back and forth to where I get this where I want. Okay, let's live with this for a minute. I'm going to click done, and then I'm going to come in and I'm going to add a little bit of sharpening. I'm coming over here on the left to my panels and click on my sharpen JPEG. Yes, this is a JPEG setting, just to give it a little bit more detail. And then I'm going to come down into my effects panel, and I'm going to add a post-crop vignette, a highlight priority, and I'm going to pull this down to about minus 25 and see how that looks. Now, let's go back, and I'm going to come to the before. There's the before. And there's the after. And I think I'm going to leave it here. I like how the snowbank and the shadows of the pier are reflected in the hull of the ship. There's a little bit of a reflection down here in the water. The whites are now white, and the blue is now blue. And the exposure has been corrected to my satisfaction based on what the scene, I remember the scene looking like I was there. So simple corrections, but powerful corrections. And again, before and after. And there you have it. So I hope you've enjoyed this week's video. Please feel free to ask questions in my comments section. For those of you subscribed to this channel on YouTube to see more post-processing videos and galleries of after before photos, visit visualventuring.com and select After Before Friday Forum in the menu. And please be sure to come back and visit next Friday for a special reveal on what week number 26, our half-yearly mark, is going to be. Thanks for watching.